Hey there and welcome to another Dave Does video, and today we're doing a priority sponsored video. So today's video has been sponsored by CG Edwards. Thank you very much for supporting the channel. You've asked me to check out the band Enisferum and One More Magic Potion. You've actually asked me to check out three songs, so I'm doing all three of your videos separately. So I'm more than happy to go and do it. So looking forward to checking this one out. We've just done, what was the one called? Stone Cold Metal, just before this. Cool track. If you haven't seen it, seen the video, go check out the reaction on that one. So this video will be scored out of four categories. We usually used to do 10. I've simplified it down to go for a different kind of content. So we're looking for four things now, which is basically lyrical connection or storytelling. So do you understand the lyrics? Do you get into the lyrics? The melody of the instrumentation on vocal harmonies. Do they connect with you? Do they convey an emotion? Basically what I'm looking for out of those two things is, do I listen to the song and feel something, or is it just the song that gets played in the background? So I'm looking for feel on that one. We're looking for hook and sing-along ability, if you like. So hook either from a melody or guitar line, something that gets you humming along, that you kind of go, that's really, really cool. Again, vocal lines, hook lines, anything like that, that just kind of gets ingrained in your head. We're looking for scoring on that. And we're looking for crossover appeal. So how many sorts of different people would get into it? Is it a very niche style of music? Is it a very niche genre? Or could different people, if someone's into R&B, would they listen to this? Or could they appreciate the song? So that's what I'm looking for there. We score it out of 100. Each category getting its own score, and then we average it at the end. So I would say a score of 50 or more is a good score. So to give you an idea, if you would score 100 on a song, that would mean that 100% of people in all categories would like the lyrics, would like everything. So if you get a score of 50 or above is a good score for a song, because that means basically at least 50% of people are going to be kind of into your track. So that's how I'm kind of judging it at the moment, based on my opinion, of course. It's just my opinion, and it's just a bit of fun to do something a bit different. Okay. Oh, it's talking so long there, I needed a coffee. Right, if you like this video, please do subscribe, click that like button, like, share, leave the comments down below. Get involved with the challenges. We have the originals versus covers, and we have the, what's the other one we're doing? Oh yes, the greatest song ever. Go check that one out, details down below. If you want to support the channel, you can do so via the Patreon. You can do these priority video requests like people are currently doing with supporting the channel, details of which are down below. They're a great way to support me and help me. You may think that paying £10 towards the channel, you do get three separate video reactions. The amount of time I spent on the videos in total, from the point of editing, putting them all together, recording it, takes three videos takes around about 3 hours. So £10 for 3 hours work is not exactly minimum wage. So please don't think I'm trying to fleece people. It's purely a case of, it does help put a few little coppers into the bank account every so often. Let's go do this one. So I've pulled the lyrics up in advance on this one, which is always a good start. I forgot to do that last time. Let's click the video. Let's go for it. Count it in. 3, 2, 1, go. Just one more magic potion. So I won't be watching the lyrics. I'm going to be looking at the same screen where the lyrics are. The video. I will be actually looking at the lyrics instead. Unless it was a live performance video, I probably would watch that one. Or if it's a specific original content one, I would. They definitely have a real folk element to this band. I can actually see them like out on tour supporting something like Nightwish, just because they've got that kind of natural folk style. But you've definitely heard more of in the last two Nightwish albums. This again, it's got a real country of Yeah. it's really interesting going and kind of reading the lyrics and trying to work out where they came on the vocal line. That whole last section vocally just didn't make any sense vocal melody wise, but you kind of fit it in. Now you can tell with someone who wrote the lyrics but had it written without the vocal line in mind, or didn't have a vocal line at the time. Nice, cool, simple chord progression, just with a little bit of keeps a nice hook and just keeps a nice type of music. Very goofy music, it's probably just vocally to the beginning. There's your kind of hooky element. Da-da-da.
Hey!
I was just sorting some bits out to the side there a minute. Ready for the next video. It's a very weird outro video. Just, what was that? So, 15 seconds of black screen. Okay, interesting edit. Nice track. I think I prefer the one before the Stone Cold Metal just because of the midsection. But you could really hear like the country elements in there, the country and also the folk elements. So you've got this real hookiness of country. And I really like hard rock country music. It's one of my favourite genres to listen to. It's I love anything that's got a real kind of country groove to it. It's traditional country, not so much, but definitely the sort of the more rock, country rock, is probably my favourite genre right now. So yeah, there's elements there that I really liked. When I listen to it from a point of connecting with a song, it's a lot harder with the kind of the heavier, growlier vocals. lyrically, it was a cool. It's got some cool lyrics in there. There's some stuff in there. I mean, there's some stuff I quite like. Close your eyes, calm your mind, and drift away from the pain beyond dreams. That's kind of cool. Into the depths of the cauldron, less so. Like a rain, it falls and mirrors nature's healing powers. Surrender this time and relief you shall find. Very cool lyric line. Then there's stuff like drink and dance, people of the forest sing with us. Who wants to brawl with me? Who can shape or can tell from a pike's jaw like the great one once did? That's less going to connect. That's very specific. There are certain elements, so I did quite like something. There were some interesting bits into there. But again, it was a very hit and miss with the lyrical content. But generally, I think it did tell a story, and it's quite interesting from that point of view. Nice, strong melody. Good hook. Again, same as the last song. I think this one has slightly less crossover appeal just because it is a little bit more... run and gun kind of just drink party song, rather than having that kind of that instrumentally piece that the last one did. So I think that's what probably makes this one not quite as crossover appeal as the other one did. But I still think it was a good track. Now, if you like this video, please do subscribe, click the bell icon, like, share, leave the comments down below. Please get involved in the challenges. Please support the channel. And that, of course, is how Dave does it.